So number system, what we have done so far, rational numbers, decimal representation of rational number we have done. Irrational number, how to represent irrational number. Okay, I think that we are doing. Representation of irrational numbers. Am I right? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, can you represent under root 2? How to represent under root 2 on number line? So that I'm explaining. Represent under root 2 on number line, first of all.
Sure, I can't see anything.
No, just I'm writing. Question is, represent under root 2, under root 3, etc. on number line. So you both of you know the Pythagoras theorem?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just 1 second, hold. So for example, I have to represent under root 2. So for that, the method is, first of all, we will draw a number line. Number line is nothing special, just a simple line. Like this, I will draw a number line. So larger number are on the right hand side, smaller number are on left hand side. And when number line is there will be somewhere zero. So let this is a zero. Now, I will take measure a distance of one unit A. Suppose this is A. So OA is a one unit. 1 centimeter, for example, you can say. OA is one unit. Now, I will draw perpendicular to this line at A such that this AB, this is AB. AB is, you understand this symbol, perpendicular to OA. That means line AB is to OA. Yes, Aditya, you can unmute yourself. So I am starting the maths representation of irrational numbers on number line. Okay. Yes, you can unmute yourself first, everybody. So Aditya, I think your mic is not working. Okay, so I am starting how to represent under root 2, under root 3, under root 4, under root 5, etc. on a number line. That irrational numbers, see, the thing is, rational numbers, integers, we can easily plot. Number line, I think everybody understands the number line. For example, if I ask you, what is the number line? This, I will come to that for number line. So between zeros will be there, then you will have one, then two, then three, then you will have plus infinity, this side minus infinity, minus one, minus two, minus three. Then if you want, you can have some rational numbers also, like 1/2. So many are there. 2 + 3/2, or any number, 2.1. Here will come 2.9, which is less than that. In this way, we can represent so many numbers. This is the number line. But problem is irrational numbers, because they are not very specific. So initially, what mathematician used to think? You know one thing. Can you hear me? You must keep on responding. Otherwise, I think you are not hearing.
Yes, sir.
So what I am saying is, you know one thing. Initially, in Pythagoras' time, there were two types of number. Were there rational number and irrational numbers? Rational numbers were thought that they are the divine numbers. Numbers created by God, and irrational numbers were the numbers they were thinking that they are the satanic numbers. They are not the God, they are anti-God. So the number system was related with God. So those who were saying that irrational number exists, they are real, then they were discarded from the society. They thought irrational numbers are not real. How this is possible? Because the numbers belong to Satan, not God. They are the evil numbers. Evil number and good numbers. That much rivalry was there. And there was one murder also because of this. First person, he told that rational numbers are real numbers. They exist. And he was asked to prove it. And when he proved, he was murdered by Pythagoreans. There was a special community was there, Pythagoreans community. Okay, that much rivalry was there because of this rational and irrational numbers. So let us not go to that all. So what I'm saying, OA and OB. OB is also equal to 1. OB length is also equal to, AB length is also equal to 1. Not OB. AB length is also equal to 1. AB is also equal to 1. So this is 1. This is 1. So if you observe here, we will get a right angle triangle OAB. In right angle triangle OAB. What will the Pythagoras theorem say here? Tell me.
OB will be root 2.
Yes, OB square is equal to OA square plus AB square is equal to 1 plus 1 is equal to 2.
So I think AOB is 45 degree and so is ABO because of the
very good
trigonometry.
Yes, yes, that is extra information. Okay, I was not expecting that you know so many things. Very good. Okay, so OB is equal to under root 2. So from here we are getting OB length is equal to under root 2 because OB square is equal to this. This is under root 2. Suppose I have to plot under root 2 on number line. Then what I will do? I will take a compass. And compass needle, that pin must be at O. With OB as an arc. OB as an length of arc. With compass so you will take this B, your pencil at B, and you will draw an arc of length OB like this. So this point is B dash. So what will be this B dash length? OB dash. OB dash will also be under root 2 because both lengths are equal. So OB dash will also be equal to OB, and this will also be under root 2. That means with this help, we are able to plot under root 2. So this length under root 2, this length is under root 2. Understood this method? Hello? Hello?
Oh, okay. Got it, sir.
Aditya, you got?
Sir, can you repeat it once more?
Okay, see, next page I am repeating it, okay? That is very clear what we have done. What I am doing here is, first I am dropping a number line. On number line, first I am marking this is the zero. Then I will take a unit one distance A, OA. So OA is equal to 1. Now at A, I will drop a perpendicular AB. This is also length 1. And if I join this triangle, OAB is a right angle triangle. So triangle OAB is a right angled. So by Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse OB square is equal to OA square plus AB square. Everybody knows this. This is equal to 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So OB is how much? Under root 2. So this is root 2. Now my work is very simple. I will take a compass. And then O as center and OC as radius. OB as radius. So O as center and OB as radius. Draw an arc. To cut the line at P. So I will draw this an arc of same length from here to cut this line at P. So this OP, to cut number line at P. So this OP is equal to under root 2. That is what I want to plot. This distance is 1, this distance is under root 2. So I'm able to plot the point on number line. This is 1, 2 will be here. So under root 2 is here. This is under root 2. Now it is clear?
Yes, sir.
Now express under root 3. Under root 3. So for under root 3, either we can draw it here directly. So what I will do, I will again take here arc this 90 degree, this one, see this perpendicular to this OB, this is OC. This is 90 degree. See, this is 90 degree. This was 90 degree. This is 1. And this is C. Can I say this OC is a right angle to this triangle? Now, OBC. See, triangle OBC. What kind of triangle it is? Blue color. Right angle triangle. Because I have drawn at 90 degree. So this triangle is a right angle triangle. Can you again apply Pythagoras theorem here? Yes, everybody apply. What is hypotenuse here? OC is the hypotenuse.
It's a root 3. It's root 3.
Yes. So OC is hypotenuse. So you can apply OC square is equal to OB square plus BC square. OB square, OB square is how much here? OB square, you can see OB square is equal to 2. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. So OC is equal to under root 3. That means this distance is under root 3. So now same thing you will do. You will take an arc of length OC with OS center and you will draw in this like this again. You can draw. From here you can draw this wherever it meets. So this point is suppose Q. So OC is equal to OQ is equal to under root 3. And this process you can keep on repeating. So again, I'm revising all this. Okay, next slide. Next page. Is it over? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Aditya. Today your mic, you have, I think, switched off. You can tell, yes. You understood all this? On chat box, you can tell Aditya. For that purpose, we have chat box also. Okay. See, now I will revise this. See how many, one after another, we can plot all these numbers. For example, now you see, I will do a bit fast here now. Okay, you can tell me, you understood or not. This is our number line, this is zero. Somewhere it is one, A. On this, I'm plotting perpendicular, 90 degree. This symbol is for 90 degree, this, 90 degree. This is 90 degree, okay? One unit. This must be equal to OA. OA and OB are equal. This is one unit. This also one unit. B. I am joining this. So by Pythagoras theorem, I got under root 1 plus under root 1. This is equal to under root 2. On this again, what I have done? 90 degree. And then again, so 90 degree will be this one unit. This is one unit. Then I am joining this. So this is C. So we have seen this OB square, OC square is equal to OB square plus BC square is equal to 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. So this implies OC is equal to under root 3. Now, this is under root 3. Same process if I repeat. Next time, what I will get? Again, here I will do the 90 degree. Again, I will join this. This is one unit. This is 3 plus 1, under root 4, means equal to 2. And then suppose they ask me, plot under root 5. Then what I will do? I will take this 2. This is 0. This is 1. So this will be under root 5. And then same process, O, this is A, B, OB as OS center, OB as arc, I will draw this radius, I will draw an arc like this. So this will be OP. This distance will be under root 5. Similarly, I can draw under root 6, under root 7, any number I can draw. So this is clear. Any doubt in this?
No, sir.
So suppose this under root, yes?
I've had no doubt, sir.
Okay. Okay. So now I will come to exponents. You have done exponents in earlier in 8th class? Laws of exponents, laws of indices. Hello?
Law, what is the second one?
Laws of indices or laws of exponents.
Yes, sir.
What is indices?
Okay. I will just ask you one question, then I will understand, okay? So write the heading, exponents or indices. A question I'm asking, you can tell me a raised to power m into a raised to power n is how much?
So a to the power of m plus n.
Mn. A to the power mn.
Mn or m plus n?
M plus n.
Oh yeah, m plus m. Oh, I forgot. Okay. It's such a long time ago. I did that in 6. I've forgotten.
My God, 6th class?
Yeah. Well, that years ago. I've forgotten now.
Yes. So Aditya, when you have done in which class?
We are to the power is multiplication, right? I'll remember yes, that now.
That I'm explaining, okay? Aditya, yeah, when you have done this, can you tell me? You have not done? 7th class you have done, very good. So now I will revise all those concepts, okay? Long back you have done. So these are very, very important. I will revise all the concepts. So these are known as laws of exponents or indices. First one, bases are same. When bases are same, product of powers. So when a raised to power m into a raised to power n is there, then the powers will get added. A raised to power m into a plus a raised to power n. Some examples I will give. Example number 1, 2 raised to power 3 into 5 raised to power 6. Sorry, 2 raised to power 6. Not 5, base must be same, otherwise we cannot do anything. 2 raised to power 6. This will be 2 raised to power 6 plus 3 is equal to 9. Clear?
So.
There may be more powers also. For example, 2 raised to power 3, 2 raised to power 5, 3 raised to power 6, 2 raised to power 1, 3 raised to power 2, 2 raised to power 4. Suppose this I have to solve. So what I will do, 2 raised to power 2, 2 raised to power 5, 2 raised to power 1, 2 raised to power 4. Similar powers I will take together and 3 raised to power 6 into 3 raised to power 2. So that I can write 2 raised to power. Now all this will be added. 3 plus 5 plus 1 plus 4 into 3 raised to power 6 plus 2. So you can write 2 raised to power 13, 3 raised to power 8. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
So we will not add the powers of head different bases are different. Because 3 base will be added with 3 base, 2 base will be added with 2 base. That is why I have separated them. 2 base is this, 3 base is separate. And finally, this multiplied. So in general, you can have a raised to power n1, a raised to power n2, a raised to power n3, a raised to power n4, a raised to power n5. This will be equal to a raised to power n1 plus n2 plus n3 plus n4 plus n5. There may be more number also, no problem. This is the first rule. So this is known as product of powers. And remember this by product of powers. product rule, product of powers. Second one is a quotient of powers. Like a raised to power m upon a raised to power n, this will be how much? A raised to power, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
From this we have one more thing. 1 upon a raised to power m can be written as a raised to power minus n or vice versa. For example, if I ask you 3 upon 2 raised to power minus 2, this will be how much? Tell me. This is how much?
So 2 by 3 upon 2. I mean, to the power 2.
Why 3 will come in denominator?
Reciprocal.
No, power of 3 is not minus 1.
Three into two to the power two. Or
yes.
Three into four.
This 3 I will keep as it is. Into 1 upon 2 raised to power minus 2. This will be 3 into 2 raised to power 2 is equal to 3 into 4. Is equal to 12. Understood?
Yes, sir.
What you are saying is, if I ask you 3 upon 2 raised to power minus 2, suppose this will become 2 upon 3 raised to power 2. This will become 4 upon 9. Mr. Aditya, your mic is not working today. Or you are muting it. I am unmuting, but I am not able to unmute anybody actually today. Yes? You can unmute yourself, no problem. For only 3 students are there, you can talk. Don't mute, Vibhu. Unmute. You will talk, no problem. Okay, so similarly, some more questions I am taking. Now, one by one, you will answer. Okay. One question is,
there's some like random messages coming in and they just keep pinging. That's why I'm keeping myself mute.
Okay, in your mobile? Okay, random messages are coming, so no problem. But you keep answering. When I'm asking, keep answering. In two.
Yes, sir.
3 upon 5 raised to power 2 into 1 upon 3 raised 3 into or 5, just like this. First to solve this, what is the answer of this?
1.
This answer?
I believe it would be 1 or something more complex.
No, how it will be 1?
Like 3 and 3, 5 and 5 cancel out that way.
No.
I'm not.
Powers are different. See, two ways are there. One way is.
Oh, wait, I got.
Raised to power 7. Yes.
I got it. 5 by 3 to the power 5.
5 by 3, power 5. Yes, Soini?
Just 1 minute.
Aditya, you are not answering. You can unmute and then answer me. Or you answer on the chat if your mic is not working. Yes? I think your mic is not working today. So you answer on the chat box. There is some problem with your mic, Aditya.
So I'm getting 5 to the power of 5 by 3 to the power of 5.
Yes. So this is how much? 3 square upon 5 square. So you can see 5 raised to power 7 upon 5 square. 3 raised to power 2 upon 3 raised to power 7. So I can write 5. This 7 minus 2 upon 3 raised to power 7 minus 2 is equal to 5 upon 3 raised to power 5.
I said that.
Or another method is just see, another simple method I will tell this. Very simple method. What you can do, you can write now this number as 5 upon 3 raised to power 7 into this number. If you reciprocate 5 upon 3 raised to power minus 2, then bases are same, powers will be added. So you can write 5 upon 3, both bases are same. 7 minus 2. So the answer will be 5 upon 3 raised to power 5. This way also you can solve.
Yes, sir.
Okay, solve one more problem. If I ask you, 7 upon 3 raised to power 9 divided by 7 upon 3 raised to power 4. What must be your answer?
7 upon 3 to the power 5.
Yes. Yeah. So now it will be 7 upon 3 raised to power 9 minus 4 is equal to 7 upon 3 raised to power 5. Aditya, your voice is not coming. So I don't know whether you understood or not. You are not telling me anything in your chat box also. Okay, very good. Okay, you can tell your answer in the chat box also. You can write and tell me. Or if you want, I will allow you to write here. Okay, you have some writing instrument. You can write on that. I can give permission for writing also. So, okay, for the time being, I have given you permission all for writing also. You can write if you have some writing instrument, if possible. Okay, next. So, third point is a raised to power 0 is always equal to 1. Okay, no problem. So, a raised to power 0, anything power 0 is always 1. But remember, it must not be 0 upon 0. Condition is a must not be equal to 0. There are some reasons of that. 0 raised to power 0 is some undefined term. Okay. Similarly, 0 upon 0, this is also undefined. Zero upon zero is not equal to zero. You must understand that.
It could equal to absolutely anything.
Yes, very good. Because what will happen, for example, 5 into 0 upon 7 into 0. Then you will cancel 0, 0. This will be 5 upon 7. So it absolutely, it can be equal to anything. Okay, so you want my previous slide? What you want? Okay. So law 2 was, I am going to the previous slide. This was the first slide, then this was the second, this was the third, afterward we started from here, first and second, product of power and quotient of power. First one was a raised to power m into a raised to power n is equal to a raised to power m plus n. Second was quotient, when they are there in the division. After noting down, tell me, I will change it. And then this, I have given some examples here. One example I have given, that 1 upon a raised to power n is a raised to power minus n. And this is the example of that. 2 into 2 upon 1 upon 2 raised to power minus 3, 2, 3 into, so 3 into 4 is equal to this. So this was example number 1, this was example number 2, this was example number 3. Okay, and this was example number 4, and this is the third rule. This is example number 4. This is the third rule, a raised to power 0 is equal to 1. Similarly, I can say that a raised to power n into a raised to power minus n. This will be how much? A raised to power n minus n is equal to a raised to power 0. This will be always equal to 1. So 2 raised to power minus 4 will be 1 upon 2 raised to power 4. 1 upon 3 raised to power 7 will be 3 raised to power minus 7. In this way, I can write. So A upon B raised to power minus 1 will be how much? B upon A raised to power minus 1. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
So I'm just revising. If you have major problem in understanding, you can tell me. I will give so many examples of this wherever you have problem. Next. Power of power. Fourth, I think. Power of power rule. That means if I have a raised to power m raised to power n, so then power will be multiplied. Power will be converted into product. A raised to power m into n. See, what is the, how to this visualize this? See, one very simple example I am giving. Suppose 5 raised to power 3 raised to power 2. This will be equal to 5 raised to power 3 into 2 is equal to 5 raised to power 6. Now, other way of visualizing this. What is A square? A square is A into A. What is A cube? A into A into A. So here, what is this? 5 raised to power 3 whole square. That means 5 raised to power 3 into 5 raised to power 3 2 times multiplied. See, square, a square, what is the meaning of square? We are multiplying the same thing how many times? 2 times. So 5 raised to power 3 whole square means 5 raised to power 3, I am multiplying 2 times. So now bases are same. So this will be 5, 3 plus 3, this is also 5, 6. So this is a very simple visualization of that rule. Okay, why this rule is true? Is it clear?
So.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see one or two more questions. I will take examples here. Suppose I ask 2/3 raised to power 4 raised to power 5 into 2 raised to power 3 into 3 raised to power 5 upon 2 raised to power 7 into 3 raised to power 2. This is equal to how much solve it? Okay. Just I'm explaining this part again. So what is the meaning of this? First of all, yes, I'm coming to that example, okay? First of all, for example, if I ask you what is A square? So A square means A multiplied by 2 times. Similarly, if I ask you, 5 raised to power 3 whole square means 5 raised to power 3 into 5 raised to power 3 multiplied 2 times. So now bases are same, so powers will be added. 5, 3 plus 3 is equal to 5 raised to power 6. And by this method, power of power method, directly you can write 5 raised to power 3 whole square is equal to 5 raised to power 3 into 2, MN, this MNC. So this is equal to 5 raised to power 6. So this is the explanation why this is correct. Similarly, this question I can write 2/3 raised to power 5 into 4, how much? 20. 2 raised to power 3, 3 raised to power 5 upon 2 raised to power 7. This you can take here also. So now see, this is how much? 2 raised to power 20 upon 3 raised to power 20. Then how much? 2 raised to power 3 minus 7, because this is the power. This is the power, 2 raised to power 7. 3 minus 7. This is 5, 3 raised to power 3. 5 minus 3 is 3. So this will be 2 raised to power 20 upon 3 raised to power 20. 2 raised to power minus 4, 3 raised to power 3. Now you add powers, very simple. So 2 raised to power 20 minus 4 2 raised to power 20 minus 4 upon 3 raised to power 20 minus 3. So you can write 2 raised to power 16 upon 3 raised to power 17. This will be answer of this. Aditya, shall I explain it again? Okay, once again I am explaining this. Everybody can understand this. So I'm deleting this. Again, I will be writing this, okay? See, first of all, I can use here. This is 2/3 raised to power 20. 5 into 4, this property. 2 raised to power 5 raised to power 3 will be how much? 2 raised to power 5 into 3, 15. 7 raised to power 2 raised to power 6 will be 7 raised to power 12. 3 raised to power minus 3 raised to power 5. This will be 7 raised to power 3 raised to power minus 15. Understood this property? A raised to power m raised to power n. So this 5 into 3 is 15, 6 into 12 is 12, 5 into 3 is minus 15. So this property we are using here. So 5 into 4 will be how much? 4 into 5, 20. So this power will be how much? 20. Then 2 raised to power 3 minus 7, because a raised to power m upon a raised to power n is equal to a raised to power m minus n. So 2 raised to power 3 upon 2 raised to power 7 is this. And this will be 3 raised to power 5 minus 2. So next step I can write, this is equal to 2 raised to power 20 upon 3 raised to power 20, 2 raised to power minus 4, 3 raised to power 3. 5 minus 2 is 3. So 2 raised to power now. How much power is there? They will add 20 minus 4. And this power will come in denominator. So this will be 3 raised to power 20 minus 3. So this is 2 raised to power 16 upon 3 raised to power 17. That will be answer. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Noted this question?
Yes, sir.
See, one more small thing formula is there. If you have, this is fifth, I think, A, B raised to power N. Sometime we need this factorization actually. So this I can write as A raised to power N into B raised to power n, like 6 raised to power 5. So 6 I can write 2 into 3 raised to power 5. So I can write this as 2 raised to power 5 into 3 raised to power 5. Or in reverse way also we can write. Similarly, A upon B raised to power N can be written as A raised to power N upon B raised to power N. This is also important, these two. Like 125 upon 343 into 243 upon 8. Suppose this I have to write. So first of all, 125 can be written as 5 cube. Check 7 square is equal to 49. 7 cube will be 49 into 7. So 343, I think. Yes. 7 cube is 343. Similarly, 243. Calculate 243. So 243 can be written as 9 into 9 into 3. So this is 3 squared. This is 3 squared. 3 raised to power 1. So 3 raised to power 7. And 8 is 2 cube. So write all this. 8 is how much? 8 is 2 cube. So write all this here. So 125. So this is 5 cube upon 343 is how much? 7 cube. 243 is how much? 3 raised to power 7. Upon this is how much? 2 cube. So if you want, you can write this in this way. 5, 7 into 214. 5 upon 14 cube into 3 cube into or 9 cube, 3 square. So 9 cube into 3. See, 3 raised to power 7, you can write 3 raised to power 6 into 3. This is 3 square cube. This is 9 cube into 3. Because why I am doing this? Because I can take now 9 also inside. So this answer can be 45 upon 14 cube multiplied by 3.
So can you repeat this last step once again?
See, this I'm writing first of all. Let me clean. So can I clean this board? So I'm cleaning this board. Okay. I will again write this so that we can have more space. See, the question is simplify 125 upon 343 into 243 upon 8. So first step is 125 is equal to 5 into 5 into 5. So 5 cube. 343 is 7 cube. 8 is 2 cube. Problem is 243. 243 is 9 into 9 into 3. This is clear?
Yes, sir.
So now I will write this everything here. This is 5 cube. This is 7 cube. This is 9 into 9 into this. So you can write this 9 into 9. If you multiply this by 3 and divide by 3, will there be any change? No change? Because I am multiplying by 3, divide by 3. So I can write this 9, 9 and 3 into 3, 9. So 9 cube upon 3. This 243. So this is a 9 cube upon 2 cube into 1 upon 3. So now see this. What is this? 1 upon 3. 45 upon 14 cube. This is a, if you observe here, this is nothing but a 1 upon 3 as it is. This is 9 into 5 and 7 into 2. This is cube. So it is 1 upon 3, 45 upon 14. This is the answer. One last example I will take of this type, okay? Yes, shall I take the example, last example? Now solve one more question. 32 upon 3 raised to power 5 into 9 raised to power 4 upon 8 raised to power 3 into 6 raised to power 5. This. Tomorrow morning I will upload this. 6 raised to power 5. This is into 6 raised to power 5. Yeah, today this is a lot of problem is coming, I know, because of this climate. Last 2-3 days I'm also getting, yes, that is why it was not possible to take class on that day. It was very bad. So I will upload this video also, no problem. See, this is...
What time is class today?
This is last example only.
Oh, okay.
This is 3 raised to power 5. Mixed type of question I have given here. So first of all, 32. 32 is 16 into 2. 16 is 2 raised to power 4 into 2, the power 1 is equal to 2 raised to power 5. 32 is this. So 2 raised to power 5 upon 3 raised to power 5. 9. 9 is 3 square raised to power 4. 8 is how much? 2 cube raised to power 3 into 6. 6 is how much? 2 into 3 raised to power 5. Next, 2 raised to power 5 upon 3 raised to power 5. Now, this will be how much? Tell me, 3 raised to power, powers will be multiplied.
To the power 8.
2 raised to power 9 into, this will be separated. 2 raised to power 5 into 3 raised to power 5. Now, it is easy. You can solve easily. Collect the powers of 2. So, this is the 2, this is 2, this is 2. So I can write 2 raised to power 5, 2 raised to power 5 upon 2 raised to power 9. First, let us write in this way. 3 raised to power 8, 3 raised to power 5 upon 3 raised to power 5. So definitely this will cancel out directly, 3 raised to power 5. So what is left? 2 raised to power 10 minus 9. 5 plus 5, 10 into 3 raised to power 8. So answer will be 2 into 3 raised to power 8.